Tuesday morning, everybody, live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee. I'm meteorologist Austen Onek with a live update of what's going on. We are live on Twitter, Periscope, Google+, and YouTube. Thanks for joining us for the latest edition of News Channel 3's exclusive video weather blog, Weather Overtime, keeping you updated as to what's going on. I'm down here in the lower corners of the screen at this time. Hello to Alex B. 1292 from Knoxville, my wife's home stomping territory. Been over there and a lot of her family in and around that area, so thanks a lot for joining us. Forecast information available again. Current conditions in the mid-60s, showers and thunderstorms throughout the day today, and more possible into this afternoon, this evening, but most of that activity should be leaving the Mid-South as we go throughout the rest of the day. Apologies for the lag time. You are still live if you are looking at this on Twitter and Periscope. We're recording this on Google and YouTube as well, but unfortunately the computer processor does have, again, a lot of stuff going on, so it's kind of hard to see this thing sometimes when it's kind of jammed up for just a little bit. We've had a tornado watch in effect for the area earlier. We now have, again, a severe thunderstorm watch in effect for the area shaded in yellow, and that's going to continue again into the area toward about noon for much of the Mid-South area. We also have a wind advisory in effect back toward Nashville for this morning. If you have any plans for traveling, you'll be looking again at the possibility of some fairly breezy conditions across much of the Mid-South area, and that again is going to be the summation of what goes on for most of the area this morning. We do not have anything showing up in the way of tornadic activity. Very good news on that, but we do have, again, some fairly breezy winds. If you take a look at what's going on in and around the Mid-South area where it comes to those winds out there, and apologies for the camera going a little wonky there. This is what happens when we have this thing happening at this time. Let's take a look and see what's going on directly in the Mid-South. Again, we've got a line of storms just past about 5 o'clock in the morning through northwest Tennessee into northeastern Arkansas, and that is going to continue to be dropping on down to the southeast. The entire line is moving toward the east, and the storms along the line are moving to the northeast at this time. So if you have any plans again for travel, this is going to be what is going to be waiting for you as these storms continue across portions of the Mid-South. We again have no active warnings immediately at this time as of about 5:06 a.m., but that could change very easily, so keep it tuned to News Channel 3 for further updates on what's going on there. Rest of the day today, again, we'll be looking for the possibility of more scattered showers and thunderstorms out across portions of the Mid-South. West Tennessee, the leading edge at this time, is making its way into around areas east of Dyersburg, west of the Humboldt area, north of Interstate 40, and going to continue that direction. Eastern Arkansas, that's where the heaviest activity is currently located. Again, we've got some fairly good amounts of thunderstorms taking place in these locations. They have been severe from time to time. We had a wind gust of approximately 66 miles per hour reported around the Walnut Wood in Memphis, Tennessee this morning, and that's where the heaviest activity has been, again, so far. That entire line is going to continue to make its way down toward the south end of the east. It's already crossing I-55 around northeastern Arkansas, and it looks like over toward areas between Forest City and Little Rock, we've got, again, some stronger thunderstorms taking place in that location. So expect more of that same line to be making its way down into around the area of eastern Arkansas and the Mississippi Valley and the Memphis metro area out there as well. Let's see, bonjour from France, Phil Drum. Thank you very much for tuning in for this morning, and glad you're sticking around for the weather forecast. And today, forecast information, we'll show you a little bit more about what's going on a regional scale. Thing fairly, again, on the quiet side south of that line from down to around northern Mississippi and back into southeastern Arkansas, but that whole line is going to continue to make its way through the Mid-South area. Throughout the next few hours, again, we're going to be looking at the what's called the Rapid Refresh Model, the HRRR. That is, again, going to be showing, again, the storms slowly at first, but then picking up speed and then moving away from the area as we go through about News Channel 3 at noon. That's when we should see the rain chances pretty well draining away from the area, so good news on that. We're going to be seeing, again, the possibility of some more hail and damaging winds with this. News lady, if I get that right, sorry, I lost your ID on there for just a second. Chance of it slowing down before it hits Memphis, as of right now, it does seem to be diminishing a little bit, but I think we should be very cautious to watch this. Again, there could be some minor spin-ups in the middle of this thing right along the line, as Dyersburg can attest to, as we've got some very breezy winds making their way through northwestern Tennessee this morning, and monitoring for the possibility of tornadoes, kind of like last week where that one way on through, and as that line made its way on through, there were tiny little tornadic vortexes that spun up around and just on the leading edge of that storm system. That could happen again today, although the signs are a lot less likely at this time. We are still going to be watching, so keep it tuned to News Channel 3 for more interest. Rest of the morning, showers and thunderstorms out there, very breezy south to southwest winds, and throughout the next several hours, again, could be looking at the possibility of some slightly cooler weather with winds turning to the northwest as the storm system begins to pass on through the mid-south area. Less chances of rainfall as we go toward around the area of, say, just before lunchtime, but the winds will continue breezy and it will be a little bit on the cooler side out there, so something to keep an eye on if you're going to be heading out the door relatively soon. So please keep that in mind. Again, for safety's sake, as these storms make their way on through the area, please remember, pull off to the side of the roadway. Give those storms some chances to move on through. If you see anything and are in a safe place, that's where you need to be able to send along information to us here at News Channel 3, and also to the National Weather Service to give them more information as to what you see going on. Walking you through the next few hours, again, the storm system should be, again, right into the metro area, right across I-40 as we go through about News Channel 3, heading into CBS this morning at about 7 o'clock this evening. Phil Drum. Yeah, that's temperature's not doing too bad, actually, for this time of the year. It's been quite mild around here for right now, believe it or not. Back into the mid to upper 50s as we head toward Tuesday late morning, and then as we get into around this afternoon, the white lines that you see on screen, notice that they start moving around to the northwest, so we start seeing a little bit cooler temperatures as that front begins to make its way on through, and most of the rainfall should be gone heading back away from us by the time lunchtime is over with in the mid-south area. Through this evening, picking up the kids from school and getting, again, the late afternoon errands ready to go as you head on home. Temperatures in the upper 50s to around the lower 60s, and winds continue out of the northwest into around News Channel 3 at 10 tonight. Well, don't forget to check out News Channel 3's Jim Jaggers. He'll be here with the forecast this evening. And, of course, Todd Demers on the air tomorrow morning on News Channel 3. Daybreak for Wednesday starting at 6 a.m. Much cooler temperatures heading on through with numbers back in the high 30s to around the lower 40s. If you'd like to see the 7 to 10 day forecast, drop by Daybreak. Todd Demers will have more on that coming up in just a little bit. The risk for severe weather at this time, light risk category, again, just around the metro area and just south for northwest Alabama, extreme southwest Tennessee, southeast Arkansas, and back into around much of northern Mississippi. That's going to be the main target bullseye zone for the possibility of severe weather. The dark green shaded category around the rest of that area, that's where we see, again, a lesser, what's called a marginal threat of severe weather, and that'll be, again, moving through the area, heading on down to the southeast as we get throughout the rest of the morning. No severe weather expected into Wednesday, and likewise into Thursday, not much, but just back to the north and west of us, a new marginal risk will be shaping up. We'll be watching that, again, with a lot of interest out there on that with News Channel 3 as we keep you advised as to what's going on. Last night's severe spotter meeting was held in Pocahontas, Arkansas. Tonight it'll be in Clarksdale, Mississippi. Saturday morning in Jonesboro, Arkansas. Next Monday at the Tunica Fire Department. Next Tuesday at Mariana Fire Department in Mariana, Arkansas. That'll be at 6:30 p.m. at the Fire Department at 22 Court Street. And coming up next Thursday, Union County. Again, New Albany, Mississippi, National Weather Service teaching these severe weather skywarn training meetings. Great opportunity to learn more about what to do before, during, and after severe weather. So please consider joining skywarn. The National Weather Service needs your eyes, ears, and brains out there to keep an eye as to what's going on, to keep it for what's happening with the, again, with weather in the Mid-South. And this is your opportunity to volunteer for stuff like that. More information available, again, at WREG.com/weather if you'd like to see more about that. My forecast podcast. If you'd like to tune in to Memphis AM radio show, Monday through Friday, 7 to 9 a.m. on AM 730 Yahoo Sports Radio, followed by Talk Back Live with Bob and Josh. That'll be coming up a little bit later on this morning. And don't forget the News Channel 3 Severe Weather app. All you have to do is just download it. Whatever platform you've got, search WREG Weather on your particular device, and you'll be able to get more information there. Questions, concerns, comments, ideas, email me at austin.onek@wreg.com, and also check out again wreg.com/weather for more information. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, I'm meteorologist Austen Onek. Stay tuned to News Channel 3 throughout the rest of the morning and into this afternoon. Should severe weather break out, we'll break in and let you know about it, so keep it tuned.